All right, boys, welcome back to another episode of Classic Angling. What's up, guys? Welcome back to another snagging episode of Classic Angling today. Today we have 2.5 hours of just complete snagging. We brought no bait, no carp rigs, just some bass lures and some big treble hooks. And so we're gonna be snagging some carp and catfish today. It's windy, so that's why I got you on the dirt. I'm not gonna put the chesty on today. I'm just gonna just roll this right in the mound of dirt. Hopefully the wind's not too bad. I'm trying to position it where it kind of blocks it, but should be able to snag, and hopefully it'll crank out a good video for y'all. Like I said, Rather Be Really supposed to be joining us today, and but he's on his way down here. He's not here yet, so in the meantime, we're just gonna see if we can catch fish before he gets here, which will most likely happen, so enjoy that. There we go. Hooked up, guys, second cast. Looks like a pretty decent one. Yeah, it's a pretty decent one. Woo! All right, we got that hook set and everything. It's not as big as I thought, but he's fighting pretty good. Just throwing that spoon. Oh yeah, it's not a big one. Well, yeah. No, not really. Hello, bud. Welcome to episode Classic Angling, boy. All right. Look, clean hook from the tail, just right there with that spoon. Y'all can see right there, perfect. So this guy's gonna probably go back. Or yeah, he's definitely gonna go back, but that's a nice solid, probably a quarter or a half pounder, between a quarter and a half. He just made a noise for some reason, but anyway. First fish of the day on the spoon. Oh, in the dirt. Classic. But we're gonna get him back right about now.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Got a better one on. Oh yeah,
we got a better one.
Ooh. Dang. See if we can land this one. This one's freaking huge. Look at that drag, guys. Oh, I had to tighten it. Thought I was hung up on like a log or something, but there's no logs out here. Oh yeah. Wait, is that two? Okay. It looked like two, but I'm not gonna get too excited, but this is a good one. Ah, man. Kinda hard to pull in when you snag him. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, that's a good one. He's hooked right in the dorsal. Yep, that's a good one. That's a good one. Alright, let's see if we can land this. Oh yeah. Loosen the drag a little bit. Very lethargic, but they still pull. Especially when you hook them broadside, they have all that resistance. So, we're gonna land this dude. All right, let's bring him up. Oh yeah. Another nice 3 or 4 pounder out of Greenways. Not bad, it took me a while to land him just cause he did not like being hooked in that dorsal fin. But, you know, they're so lethargic, they have all this energy stored up in them. And that's just what makes them fun. So, you get weight on this guy and then put him back. Lay him on the landing mat right now, so y'all can see. I'm gonna stick it on the wind. Oh, that's the wrong way. Yeah, he's gonna chill there, and we're gonna get a scale on him real fast. Tips the scale. That's another 3.5 pounder. Real close to 4, but if you take away the weight of the bag and the wind blowing it, then it's about 3 or 4 pounds. About 3.5, so. They're a nice Greenwich giant in this bag. we're gonna get a nice, solid, proper release. What this is, basically you got a slide sinker, a snap swivel, and then a large shovel hook. And what you're gonna do is just yo-yo it, kinda like you would that lipless, but I missed quite a few fish on that lipless, so we're gonna see if this catches a fish.
First cast, the actual snagging. It's not huge, I just saw him jump out, I just pulled clear out of the water, but
sure is fighting for a little guy. The bend in that rod. I just jerked once and I had him, and he came flying clear out of the water.
Alright, come here, bud. Yeah, not a bad one. Alright, we're gonna set him on the landing mat. Yeah, just hooked him
right in the back there. He just came flying out of the water.
That was cool.
Alright, we'll get him unhooked. Alright, boys. Don't go into the camera, you weirdo. God. Alright, freaking jerked y'all to the side there. Odd. Okay, so this fish is not well behaved, so we're just gonna throw him back. There he goes. He jumped again. Now we'll get another one on this snagging rig. And then the second cast after that last fish, I caught a tiny bullhead. They're very shallow. It's very shallow on that shallow flat back there. And it was just an accident. Yeah, I think he's dead. That, look at that. The hook's pulling right out. I thought I had like a leaf or something, and then I just pulled up. That little guy was on it. But anyway, I casted shallow on accident just because I haven't casted this thing in forever. And I got a tiny, tiny bullhead. We'll get him off the hook and hopefully he lives. I mean, he swam back, but he kind of pricked me. Kind of hurt. He barely tapped me and it kind of hurt. I swear, those little bullheads, they just have the sharpest spines. And they sting like heck. And yeah, I wasn't about to mess with it a little more, but let's see if we can get another one. Guys, this rig is so fire. Look. Okay. Yeah, tell me what you see that's kind of odd. That bullhead is barely hooked, but I hooked that carp in the face. Look at that. That's a double. It looked like a leaf and then it started fighting. I'm like, what on earth? But they're stacked in the shallows. Again, another accidental cast. Because I just can't cast with this big bulky rod, but that's cool. We'll get them both off the hook and we'll release them.
Alright boys, just threw the spoon and look what I caught.
Hey.
I caught a goldfish. I caught the snack
that's miles back.
About to say, if it was a channel cat, I'd be flipping out.
Another little shiner.
Now, that rod tip's on my head.
You're good.
Alright, hook them right in the scale. Yeah, not bad. If it was summer, I'd be putting them in my pond. Or the aquarium. I think in the aquarium, because it'll be smaller than the one I have now. There we go. Yeah, I put the big one in the pond. Oh, hello. Yeah, it may not look like it, but this is a goldfish. So there's the orange back and stuff, but that's a nice chubby little goldie. Let's put him back. All right, bye, bud. All right, guys, check this out. We got double.
Double on the double hook, guys. Got one baby carp and then a little shiner hanging around with them.
There's even
the
get
little
triple.
Baby carp.
Maybe a quadruple. Yep. Oh, crap. Well, I guess a double.
You
now
had one? And a little shiner?
Oop.
Little shiner, guys. That would be perfect catfish bait.
Oh, I missed one. Wait. Yeah,
I already threw him back.
Oh, well. It was close, though. No. Okay. All right, got another good one, guys. Oh yeah, this guy's pulling. Yep. We got a puller. Oh gosh. I got this 10-pound, this is 10-pound test braid. I got locked down. And these small carp are just pulling them. Come on, bro. All right, come on. Oh, you got him? We're gonna get another double? All right, let's do it. Guys, we got goldfish carp double. I got the carp and look what he has. Oh gosh, oh, I thought you lost him.
No, I thought he was gonna.
Yeah, barely hooked on that little spoon, guys. All right. Bro, you hooked him right in the mouth. Hooked him in the mouth. All right, but yeah, oh gosh.
Got that nice, pretty goldfish.
Got that nice, succulent carp.
All right, both going back.
All right, we're gonna throw the old husky jerk. It's got some really sharp trebles. And, oh, you got one. He broke off on the little double hook, and so he's using my treble hooks. But yeah, I got a tackle box full of crazy bass lures and stuff. And we're going to be using this to see if we can catch one. All right, boys, for first fish ever on this little husky jerk. It's a little shiner. This thing doesn't cast in the wind worth a crap, but Jackson said that he's hooked up. Are you still hooked up? Oh, there he is. All right, come here. Bro, look how beat up this shiner is. Look at that. Oh, on this side. Or yeah. Yeah, come here. I got my shiner. Look at that. Little tiny shiner. I'm going to see if I can lip lock it. Here. Come here. Everybody. Are you recording?
Yeah.
Awesome.
All right,
there we go, guys. All right.
See, here's him. Oh, dude, he looks like almost like a bass killer.
I know, he's kind of sickly, so. Ah. All right, so there we go. Yeah, it's right there. So, let's go.
All right, guys, got goldfish.
Flip on the lipless. On the lipless crank.
Right out. Look at how big this goldfish is. Look at this. Put him right in the fin.
Oh my god.
Perfectly.
Jake.
Bro, it's a small.
Goldfish.
Is there a gold? We got goldfish double. Look at that, guys. Oh, it's just a carp. Okay, no big deal. Look at that goldfish, guys. Beautiful. We'll put him back. Oh, he just skirt. He said, I'm out of here. Screw your lipless crankbait. We're going to catch another one. All right, switch back to the spin cast, guys. Got our small one. Ha! I'm stepping all over all my rods. Come here, bud. Come here! Oh, it's small. Right in the shallows. Not bad. Get this guy on hook real fast. Just hooked right in the side. Right there. Perfect. All right, here we go again. Got another one just slightly bigger than the last one. Oh! Oh! I just ran him right into a rock.
Oh, yeah, I got one.
Sorry, sucker mouth. All right.
I didn't have one at first, but now I got one.
Yeah, I see the bend. Switch back to the spoon. And it's one of the top lures for today, I'll tell you that.
Got another one. This one feels pretty big. Either that or he's just turned broadside. Or I have a double. Is that double? Oh, no. No, he just turned broadside. Come here. Be our guest.
Another one about the same size.
Bro, I freaking love these things. They're freaking... These are the F1 carp. They're a hybrid between a crucian and common carp. He murked it. I thought he actually ate it. He murked it so hard. So, oh, dang. Dang it. Come on. Come on, bro. Chill. Oh, I love these fish. I remember I used to catch these all the time down here in June and July. They fight so... They jump. They fight harder than... You know, common carp this size. So that's how fun these fish are to catch. So he's gonna go back. He went skirt.
Okay, guys, as you can probably tell, I'm freaking soaked in mud, and it's because of this monster. Look at that. That's an easy 4 or 5 pounder all day. I was gonna turn the camera off just because we've been filming so much of this episode, but I guess we'll end with this fish. This is awesome. Look at this. I mean, that's a beast. I caught it on that spoon. I thought I was hung up on a log, and then he started kicking and stuff. And I was like, yeah, I got a huge one. Rather be running across the lake. He just caught his personal best bullhead just a second ago. And I took a picture for him on that. And so, hopefully, I'm using a tackle box as a windlock. Yep, that didn't work. But, anyway, I freaking caught a giant, guys. Oh, we're going to scale him real fast. Oh gosh, he's still got a ton of energy. He soaked me when I was trying to land him. And look at the girth on that thing. Ugh, chill. Okay, I'm just gonna leave him on the landing mat. We're just gonna scale him. And chill. And then we're gonna release him. All right, we'll get the scale fast. Okay, guys. Okay, yeah, I'm filming. Okay. So this fish is topping the scales at about 4.5 pounds. Take away the bag, that's about another 4-pounder. Oh, this thing was awesome. All right.